Welcome guys to my YouTube channel, and this is my first video on YouTube, so let's get started. But before we start, I want to welcome you to my channel, and please subscribe to my channel as we start this journey together of learning mathematics. And with our first topic, where we are going to learn more about Bayesian probability, and we are going to learn through an example. So let's do this example together. Now the question goes as: a patient are recruited onto the two arms, that is zero represents the control and one represents the treatment. Of a clinical trial, the probability that an adverse outcome occurs on the control arm is PO and is P1 for the treatment arm. The patients are allocated alternately onto the two arms, and their outcome are independent. What is the probability that the adverse event occurs on the control arm? So here we are looking at the probability that the adverse event occurs on the control arm. So solution, we start by labeling our events for easier solution. So as usual, we start by sample space. The sample space, we denote it by S, and E1, which is the event that the first patient allocated onto the control arm suffers an adverse effect, that is E1, and E2 is the first patient allocated onto the control arm does not suffer an adverse effect, but the second patient allocated onto the treatment arm suffers an adverse outcome. And E0 is neither the first two suffers adverse effect. And F is the first adverse event occurs on the control arm. So this is the probability which you are finding, the question is asking. So as a diagrammatic illustration is where I've drawn for you, that this rectangle here, it's the sample space, and E1 inside here, it's just the different adverse effects of E1, E2 and E0, and F now is the general first advance effect to occur. So to find the probability of F happening, that is the first advance effect occurring on the control arm, we use the total probability theorem, which is denoted by this. To find the probability of F, we find the probability of F given each event happening, that is F given E1 happening, F given E2 happening, and F given E0 happening. So to find that, we are supposed first to find the probability that the probability of each element, so that you can find the probability of F. For the probability of E1 happening, it is P0, which was stated earlier in our question, and the probability of E2 happening, it is 1 minus P0, because E2 is where, as we can go back to our question where we say E1 is the first allocated onto the control arm suffers an advance effect, and E2 is where the first does not suffer an advance effect in control arm, but suffers an advance effect in the treatment arm. That's why it is 1 minus P, the probability of E2, and the probability of E0, that where neither of them suffers an advance effect, we are going to use the multiplicative rule in probability, where we will find the probability of E1 not happening and the probability of E2 not happening. So to get this, the 1 minus P1 times 1 minus P1, and then to find the probability of F given E1 happening, it's going to be 1, because here f is finding the first advance effect occurs in the, and here you're finding the probability of the first advance effect occurring in the control room, given that the first, given that the event that the first person entering the control room does not suffer an advance effect. So the logic of the statement, you find that the probability is equal to zero, and the probability of finding the first advance effect occurring in the control room, given that the neither of the first two patients suffers an event if advance effect, is equal to the probability of the first advance effect occurring, in that when you find that neither of the two first, the first two patients suffers an advance effect, it means you'll have to find the, then you have to recur the trial again, and recurring the trial again, it means you have to find the probability of the first person, the first event, the first advance effect on the control room. So that's why you'll find is the probability of this is equal to the probability of this. So just by, given that you have denoted all our probabilities, so we replace them in our equation, and this is the probability of the one, this is given E2, and this is given E0. So when we summarize the equation, we find it to be this. So as mathematicians, we tend to simplify our work and arranging our work into a nice expression. So when we arrange our work and we calculate, and as you follow the steps slowly, you'll find that all this equation, it will turn up to be this nice equation here, where when you use this equation, you can use it to find the probability of the first advance effect occurring on the control room. When, for example, you have the real figures without these P0 and P1, when you have the real numbers, you can replace them into this equation and find your probability. So yeah, that's our first example, and maybe you didn't understand us when we did it together, but you can rewatch the video again and again, and you understand it very well. So without further ado, we are going to end our session, but please subscribe, share and like to this YouTube channel, and also call out to your friends so that you can share and comment also, so that we can find several examples and teach each other maths. Okay, bye, see you next time on Monday, same time, same place, with another mathematical question so that we can solve it together. Bye.